I'm gonna show a little more detail on how this was mounted to the wall and how the light was mounted to the scissors. On this particular light, this little ball joint was part of the original lamp assembly. And I took that off and glued it into this wooden doll. Actually, this wood doll will turn in this piece. It's a friction fit. And it just gives you another range of motion for this. Just a metal threaded insert that's in here. You can make these star knobs yourself. This star knob is operating on a bolt. It just squeezes this tight. This piece just has a wooden dowel running through this slot. A couple of fender washers to keep that wooden dowel in place. And I've done it this way so I can take it apart again if need be. This slot is cut parallel with this link when it's closed. The mounting mechanism, just a wooden dowel that pivots in the top of this block and then the bottom. So you can go left to right. And here, you just have some spacer washers that are made out of wood. And there's a wood dowel that runs through that. And again, fender washers to keep them in place. The same thing up here at the top. Some spacer washers, a wooden dowel, and these fender washers just keep everything in the center of this bracket. A little bit about strength. When this is collapsed, that's as strong as it gets. As you extend this, this is a bridge truss. Most bridges, that's about as far as you're going to see the angle extended on a bridge design. And this is still quite strong. I've allowed this to come all the way out to here, and this is starting to pick up a little flexure in it. You can adjust your range of motion by how long you make this slot. If you want more extension on your scissors, add more links. That's about as far as I extend it when I'm using it. If you come all the way out here and you put too much weight or pressure on here, you will break the scissors.